Now it's a dramatic night for Coronation Street's Jenny. She gets caught up in husband Johnny's criminal past.
You think you're a big man, do you? Holding a gun to a young woman's head, shooting poor Craig. How long do you think it's going to take him to get over that? Unlike you, Johnny wouldn't hurt another living soul.
Really? Is that right? Mm. What about his little mishap when we did that warehouse job? Oh, I take it didn't bother to tell you about the security guard.
What?
Your precious husband ran over him. Bloke was lying there, bleeding. All Johnny could think about was himself. He legged it, left him for dead.
Ooh, well, Sally Ann Matthews, who plays Jenny, joins me now. It's so good to see you and a little
and
pal.
You.
Oh, look, is this Vito?
I know. This is Vito. He's just decided he wanted to play.
He's gorgeous.
Wrestle, but I'm not going to encourage him.
No, he's gorgeous. He looks like my Angus. Well, they are the same. They are Border Terriers.
Oh, they are the same breed.
They're the bestest dogs. And how well behaved. Look at them. Look, do you know what? When all this is over, we have to get them to play. We'll get them on a play date because I think they get on really
Definitely.
Well.
Definitely.
I think they get on really
Definitely. Well. Definitely. Go for a nice long walk.
Absolutely. Oh, gosh. Wouldn't that be nice? Coronation Street, goodness me, poor girl. She's finding out things about her husband that she had no idea. It's the end, really, isn't it? She's not going to put up with that.
She's not having a good time, really, is she? I mean, Johnny has really put her through the mill over the last few years, and this recent escapade, what is going to happen to their marriage? I think for Jenny, you know, there's a lot of throwbacks to her relationship with her father, really. You know, even though she found what Alan did totally abhorrent, she loved him, and it's the same with Johnny. Even though she's found out here's what happened in the past, she loves him, and even though she absolutely despises the act that he's done, she loves him. So she's got this real kind of conflict going on at the minute.
And it's so interesting what you said about her dad, because, of course, we all remember that iconic, I mean, it's one of the Corrie moments, isn't it, when Alan Bradley tried to kill Rita. And he got run over by
Jenny's 18th birthday.
I know. I mean, that is one of those moments that you never forget. Whenever we do, because you know it's going to be Corrie's 60th, obviously. That's going to be one of the moments. And of course,
more than likely that they will put because it is, as you say, it's a massive part of Corrie's history.
Of course it is. And
but it's very odd for me because I started work at Corrie the Monday after they'd had their 25th anniversary celebrations.
Gosh.
That's 35 years ago.
I know. And then, of course, you came back. But Barbara Knox at the time, when you started out as a young actress and you were, you know, finding your way, Barbara Knox gave you some really good advice, didn't she?
She really did. I mean, I was very fortunate that I was with Barbara, I was with Thelma Barlow, and I was with Mark Eden. So I just soaked up everything that they had to say. But Barbara warned me off. Not that I was interested in it particularly, but the whole fame and celebrity circus, which it is a bit of a circus, isn't it? Yeah. We all know they kind of go hand in hand. But Barbara gave me choice words about that. So she's still quite scary now, I have to say.
She's street royalty. I mean, I don't know why she's not
she
a dame.
Is.
She should be a dame. She's just incredible.
I know. She should be. She absolutely should be.
But then, of course, came back.
Well, she is in our eyes anyway. We all call her Dame
Barbara.
So.
Of course, absolutely. And you came back, and was it just like coming home when you came back? It must be 4 or 5 years ago now.
It's six.
Wow.
6 years ago.
Gosh.
Now. I know. It flies by, doesn't it?
It does. It really does.
It was. I kind of describe it as meeting a long-lost relative, really. You feel a familial connection to them, but they're actually strangers. And that's what it was like going back, because obviously I'd had 22 years between this recent comeback and the previous one. And the show had changed completely. But then I'd been working throughout that time. So I was used to the whole rehearse, record process that television in general has moved into. So there were a lot of familiar faces. The ethos of the place was exactly the same. However, it was all very different.
Yeah, it is. And of course, right now, thank goodness you're still able to film. And there's ways round all of this, isn't there? I mean, it's been very clever.
There is.
Yeah, it's clever, isn't it, the way they've
done
it?
I mean, our production managers have been exceptional on both Corrie and Emmerdale. Matt Cleary and Lee Rayner and Nada over Emmerdale have been able to get us back to work safely. And we have a very strict one-way system and a 2-metre rule to ensure everyone's safety at work and to make sure that we can keep the program going. And it just means for us, creatively, we have to find new ways of doing things, you know, where ordinarily somebody was crying, you go and give them a hug and you can't do that. So you have to find a different way of expressing that emotion, but staying 2 meters away. I love it. In the script, it says, you know, she goes, she embraces him, brackets, at a 2 meter distance.
Yeah, you have to. And all these scenes, you know, all these dramatic scenes when her life is in danger that we're going to see through, you know, tonight and then throughout next week, of course, hard enough to film those scenes, but really difficult right now, you know, that's the thing.
It is, particularly scenes like that, as you say. I mean, we are relying on the audience to go with us a lot of the time. And I think, you know, we've found that they are, because there is something that if a man has got a gun, to, you know, pointing at you, oh, look at me with my fingers, it's very scary, that you will move. And so whether you move in that direction or in that direction, completely the opposite way from where he and the gun are, you just have to, because when you've got three actors, we have to kind of be in a 2 meter triangle.
Yeah.
So we're expecting and hoping and enjoying the fact that the audience are going with us when we have got scenes that we have to film at a distance.
Exactly, exactly. Well, look, are you going to be able to take little Vito out for a walk today?
Yeah, it's not looking too bad down here today. It's cloudy. I might actually be going out for a run.
Of course. I
know that you're aware that I'm doing, crazily, because I turned 50 a month ago and I started the Couch to 5K program and I loved it. And so I decided I wanted to do something to keep going. And I'm going to be doing 50 5K runs in my 50th year. And Vito comes with me.
Oh.
And as soon as he sees me get my trainers out, he gets very excited. And I think he thinks, he goes, oh, damn, I remember this bit. I have to run 35 minutes.
He's absolutely
gorgeous.
It's
great exercise for me and it's great for him. And I'm raising money for charity.
It's fantastic. It's fantastic. It really is, Sally Ann. I mean, I salute you. 55K runs. That's very, very...
Well, I've done 7 so far. So I don't even know who I am anymore, Lorraine.
You'll be great. So lovely to talk to you. Corrie's on tonight, actually. Double dose of Corrie. 7:30 and 8:30 tonight on ITV. And of course, we will be watching. You take care of yourself. And your little dog is gorgeous. We'll get our boys together. We'll get our boys together and they can be best pals. It'll be lovely. Thank you. Thank you so much. Don't forget, you can watch full episodes of Lorraine on the ITV Hub and all the best clips, compilations and playlists right here on our channel. Just subscribe now and you'll never miss an upload. Click here to watch another video similar to this one, or click here to head to our channel's homepage to explore all of our exciting videos.